Well, if you've been, I mean, if you've been caught in possession of drugs today, regardless of when the summons arrives, and it will arrive, that's 100% guarantee. You can't guarantee much in life, but I can guarantee you a summons for court for drugs. They will summons you. You should start your analysis. I recommend that to every one of my clients. Your analysis is really important. It's scientific. You go to your GP. Your GP nominates someone who can do your analysis. There's a bit of a cost involved. But if you want the court ultimately to leave you with your record, they are more inclined to do that if they know it's cost you a bit of money. If it's cost you time and money to do it, it means that your protestations of I'm through with drugs carry more weight. And so the judge then can be more inclined to say, all right, I'll take a chance on this person. I won't convict them. If you're summoned to court for possession of drugs, you should get legal advice. You don't have to. You can represent yourself if you want. It's not something that pretty much any judge recommends. And in fact, if you come into court without a solicitor, the judge will ask you pointedly if you want to get a solicitor. Of course, you can refuse if you want, but it's not advisable. You should get a solicitor because they know the implications of a drugs conviction, maybe more than you do. And most judges like to see people represented because it's in their best interests. If you're represented, you're not likely to say something against your best interests. Sometimes people come into court, they represent themselves, and they blurt out something, maybe because of nervousness, that actually makes their case worse. So you should look at seriously getting yourself represented by a solicitor, yeah. Well, if you're stopped by the guards, there's one of two ways of stopping you, whether it could be a mandatory intoxilizer checkpoint where they're mandated to be at that place at that time, at that particular date, to carry out the saliva samples or breath tests. And if that is the case, they're entitled to be there. If they demand from you a sample of your saliva at one of these mandatory checkpoints, you must give it. If you don't, you're breaking the law. That's one way of looking at it. The other way of looking at it is where you're stopped after they observe you driving, and that's a different situation entirely.